Hi, I'm Maggie Lukowski from Maggie Moon Tarot, and here are the vibes for the week. Here in the Northern Hemisphere, we've moved into the fall season, and our sun has changed signs and is now in beautiful Libra. This weekend on Sunday, the 27th, we'll experience the full Aries moon, a super moon, the harvest moon or blood moon, and that will light the fire of our desires for the start of our new season. We also experience a total lunar eclipse, a burst of cosmic energy. Here in North America on the East Coast, we can see the full eclipse. And I have a link in the About section of the video as to where it can be viewed in other regions of the world. And eclipses are powerful, and lunar eclipses can bring changes, endings. It can be an emotional and sentimental time, releasing what does not serve us or is relevant now, moving us forward, which can be a good thing. It's also good not to make big pronouncements. Let a few days pass. Often there's a lot of news during an eclipse. And this is big energy and can be felt for some time. It can also have a delayed effect. So we can look at our chart to see what house it falls in and how it may affect us. And eclipses are mixed bags, the wild card or a happy squirrel card. So there's nothing to fear. The universe is calling us forward. And on the same day in China, they celebrate the summer's harvest with the Moon Festival. People travel back to their home for reunions, to have dinner with their family, and enjoy mooncakes. And the roundness of the moon and the cakes represent peace, prosperity for the family, completeness and togetherness. They have a special saying and wishes, and I liked this one for us, wishing us a long life to share the graceful moonlight, though thousands of miles apart. And then on Tuesday the 29th, we celebrate the Feast of St. Michael and all of the angels. And on Wednesday, the Libra Sun conjuncts Mercury, a great time to express ourselves with flair and clarity. This is the day to get our big message across, and people will be listening. You may get those light bulb moments, so write them down, so then we can take action on them. And this is our last week in Mercury retrograde, yay, before it begins to go direct and to start to move forward the following week. So it gives us time to do any research or reviews before we jump into action. And this week for the reading, I wanted to add a little magic since we have changed seasons here. And in the Northern Hemisphere, the cool breezes brush up against us. I chose The Wizard Tarot by Corinne Kenner and illustrated by John J. Blumen. And this deck comes with an excellent companion book filled with magical powers and charms for the minors and for the practical magic and spreads for each major arcana card. We are welcomed into Mandrake Academy. We step into its chambers and magical studies and listen for the messages and for the wisdom this week. And for the beginning of the week, the Queen of Wands comes out. And she's one of my favorite cards of the Royals. And it's a great start for our week. Her fire shines hot and bright. The orb behind her looks like our full moon, and the mooncakes and her wand and vessels beside her remind us of the Aries full moon. And her astrological correspondence is Aries. Passion was a bit of Pisces poured in, nurturing. She is a multitasker, a brilliant businesswoman. And in the companion book, it talks about her being the guardian of fire. She is a protector, and she was born and raised to defend and preserve the realm of fire. She can get us excited to reach out to others, be that cheerleader for ourselves and people around us. And also, we may seek out a mentor to help us if we feel stuck or if the flame on our burner is a bit low. And the element of fire is of spirit, creativity, and inspiration. And as protectoress, she will not let our fire go out or get burnt. We can use her energy to accomplish anything we desire. And midweek, another royal, the King of Swords. His element is air. He is ruler of air. He leads with confidence and has new ideas, a good communicator, and logic are his strong suits. His gifts are hearing the messages from the wind, and his astrological correspondence is Gemini with a bit of Taurus. added in, and we can benefit from his advice. Taurus is grounding and sensual. Gemini can get much accomplished at once and is excellent in communications, like this King of Swords, a master at our message, a winning combination for negotiations this week. It comes around the same time that our Virgo Sun conjuncts Mercury. A portal opens for successful new visions. And eagles are soaring high in the sky behind this king, a symbol of the Great Spirit. Eagle medicine represents clear vision, can help us look at things with new eyes. His white feathers on his head stand for truth and justice. His gifts are freedom, good timing, and accuracy. In time to take actions on our visions. And with the king, diplomacy can give us that advantage. And a king is at the pinnacle of his suit, and like the full moon, he can also remind us of releasing any old ideas or beliefs that no longer serve us, release the judgment and assumptions around those beliefs, as they can block our own inspiration. And then by doing that, we get that vision of loving brilliance and the freedom to fly. And at the end of the week, the Two of Pentacles comes out. Pentacles element is earth, and this card's magical power is balance and adjustment. And his magical charm is to focus on this card when trying to balance our budget, time, and tasks. We might be juggling two jobs, trying to keep all the balls in the air, or as the expression goes, not dropping the ball. And the astrological correspondence for this card is Jupiter in Capricorn. And Jupiter might want us to expand the work Capricorn's doing and might place us in a bit of overload. And the coins are in a figure eight, which is the infinity symbol. And eight in numerology is about manifesting finances and making any adjustments in this area. We're in an 8 month and 8 year in numerology. So there's added emphasis in these areas. And the oak tree in the background reminds us of strength and endurance and how we can be grounded into the earth. We can get through this. And if we're in a period of trying to balance our resources, and much is going on, we can be certain that this too shall pass, and we won't be juggling so many balls in the future. This card can also hint that we take a more playful approach to life. And that, my friends, are the vibes for the week. If you've enjoyed this video, I invite you to click on the like and subscribe button and share with your friends. I've included a link in the About section of the video, one for the Wizards Tarot, and a link to my website, MaggieMoonTarot.com, in case you'd like to contact me or schedule a reading. So, until we meet again next week, laugh often, love much, create your own happiness, believe in miracles and magic, be kind, support each other. Namaste.